Interference suppression is significantly improving long and shortwave listening. See the summary of root cases and simple but effective solutions. Apparently, many shortwave listeners are suffering from it. When I recently rediscovered shortwave listening with my SDR receiver, the first thing I noticed was terrible interference. It's in my DNA as an RF expert, I have to face the challenge of eliminating the problem. But no worries, we won't suggest expensive professional solutions. It's about simple and effective methods that anyone can implement. Besides my experience with a local SDR, massive interference is also occurring with web SDRs. It's a great project. People are making their SDR receivers available to everybody over the internet. You can control SDR receivers at remote locations, almost the same way you can control your own one directly connected to your PC. There are hundreds of them. Just search the internet for web SDR. Some of them are achieving excellent reception, thanks to a good location and a sophisticated network of various antennas, filters and attenuators. I will link you to some very good web SDRs in the video description. However, many receivers, like mine, are operated under non-ideal conditions. And there are cases where interference is even worse than mine, affecting all long, medium and shortwave bands. In this video, we are showing how to get more out of it. You can really make big improvements with little effort. We are now explaining effective solutions while answering these questions. But first, I'd like to draw your attention to a great anniversary. PCBWay, the sponsor of this video, is celebrating 11 years of unstoppable progress. There is a lottery going on with great prizes, and there is much more to discover. Just check out their website for great offers on products and services. Take the easy way with PCBWay. Besides crystal clear audio, high signal strengths and SNR are technical indicators of good reception. A low noise floor, for example at -130 dBm, is allowing us to receive weak signals from distant stations. In case it is high as here, weak signals are literally drowning in noise. Strong noise peaks like these can be particularly disruptive, as you can imagine. Typical sources are switching power supplies, voltage converters, and clock signals from PCs or other digital devices. Their harmonics can occur in all frequency bands. Mixed products of hundreds of in-band and out-of-band signals are raising the noise floor far above the thermal noise of your receiver, reducing its sensitivity accordingly. Interfering signals are coming over the air and via cable. You can reduce the interference coming through the supply or data cables applying ferrite blocks and cable loops. The inductance of the chokes is reducing currents, which are an effect of sheath waves propagating along the cables. Just apply them wherever you can, including the antenna feed line. This way, I reduced interference a lot on my SDR receiver already. Just as a side note, Attaching chokes to suspect devices' power cables is preventing them from coupling interference into the power grid. The majority of interfering frequencies originates in our receiver, because it doesn't have particularly good preselection, making it sensitive to intermodulation. This is where the raised noise floor is actually coming from. A simple wire loop antenna with a balloon is picking up less unwanted signals, as its bandwidth is smaller than the one of a dipole, and it's delivering a stronger signal for low frequencies. The measures mentioned are improving a lot. However, from my experience, some interference peaks are remaining in the lower frequency bands. Grounding the coax shield at the antenna feed point can help to eliminate or at least reduce the remaining noise. But you need a really thick, well-conducting connection to the ground. The reason is interesting, by the way. Our ground wires and shields are essentially forming a large loop, picking up all kind of electromagnetic waves. In an earlier video, we explained that the loop's radiation impedance is extremely low at low frequencies. You can think of it as an interference signal generator with a low internal resistance. Our chokes are increasing this internal resistance, but are less effective at low frequencies. This explains why the interference is so persistent in the lower frequency range. So, if we want to prevent the remaining interfering currents causing voltage here, we need a highly conductive wire discharging them to the ground. Experiments with thin wire are showing decreasing interference, but you need a thick conductor to eliminate it. I'm showing you very low frequency and all broadcast bands from longwave to shortwave. And by the way, the results on the amateur radio are similar. Starting with terrible interference, we managed to get all frequency bands almost completely clean. This comparison is between a dipole and a simple wire loop of 2 meters diameter. We explained how to build it in an earlier video. In both cases, ferrite chokes are attached to the power supply cables, the USB data cable and the antenna cable. Without the chokes, we would receive almost nothing but interference. The loop antenna with the grounded antenna feed point is introducing a huge improvement at lower frequencies. This is really remarkable, considering it's an indoor antenna. Of course, I don't get the same superb signal strength as the high-end web SDR side shown before. But at least, signals are significantly stronger on lower frequencies, the noise is significantly reduced, and the interference peaks are almost gone. I can receive about 10 times more radio stations that were not available before. Unbelievable how far the reception can be improved by simple means. This makes shortwave listening really fun again, and I think it's manageable for everybody. In the higher frequency range, the loop's signal strength is decreasing and the dipole is better at some point. Radio frequency technology isn't black magic, but I must admit, some effects aren't easy to understand, even for experts. Anyway, some simple hacks are bringing significant improvements. Hoping the video is helping you to improve your SDR's long and shortwave reception. Please don't confuse the magnetic loop with the resonant lambda loop, which we developed for frequencies above 100 MHz. If you are interested, there is a whole video series about it on our channel. Maybe advanced measures would be worth another video? Write me in the comments. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.